In K-pop, and specifically girl groups, the typical image relies heavily on a clean, innocent, and wholesome image. The group's image is a big factor in the group's success in a competitive industry like K-pop. This in turn helps groups secure sponsorships and promotions, and any negative history of press can heavily affect their position in the K-pop ladder. Today's video, we'll be discussing the controversial debut of Honey Popcorn and how K-Nuts got the South Korean government involved to ban this group from ever debuting in South Korea. Hi everyone, and welcome back to Midnight Theories. And if you're new here, welcome to Midnight Theories. Forget everything you thought you knew about K-pop. Welcome to your new home for all K-pop related theories, urban legends, and news. Enjoy your stay, consider dropping a like, subscribe, and don't forget to hit that bell to be notified when I release a new video. Honey Popcorn is a Japanese girl group based in South Korea. They were originally a three-member group under Kyun Create. Now, I say originally just because the member lineup has changed over time, but more on that later. The original lineup included Yua Mikami, Moko Sakura, and Matsuna Miko. Before their K-pop debut, all three members were J-pop idols under popular groups such as SKE48 and NMB48. It became quite a shock to long-term fans of Yua when she made the announcement that she would be debuting as a member of Honey Popcorn, and she would follow the path as a K-pop idol. The thing about this group that caused quite the controversy was not that they were all foreigners trying to make it in the K-pop industry, but actually their past careers, and I'm not talking about J-pop. Prior to the trio's debut, all three original members were former AV actresses, which, for K-pop standards in South Korean culture, is very taboo. Not only that, but it is also illegal to consume or produce that kind of content. In J-pop, it is not uncommon for idols to transition from idol to AV work after they graduate from their respective groups. It is actually pretty common for J-pop idols to do magazine spreads and photo books that hold a more mature concept. The most common girl group image was to give off the impression of bubbly innocence and purity. Nevertheless, in more recent years, it has changed into more girl crush, flashy, and independent concepts. News of this girl group's debut caused unavoidable controversy, so much so that petitions were made to ban the group from debuting entirely. The petition even reached South Korea's Blue House. In total of 35,000 signatures were signed against this group. Thousands of Korean netizens flocked to the forums to show their distaste for the group, and such comments as "go back to Japan" and "since when did adult actresses become in the same rank as idols" were made. K-Nuts felt the group would influence their youth negatively and damage their innocence. Honey Popcorn did eventually debut on March 21st, 2018 with their song "Bibbidi Bobbidi Boo." K-Nuts were not able to get the group banned, but they did unfortunately get the group's showcase cancelled, or so they thought. Kyun Create did announce that they would be cancelling Honey Popcorn's debut showcase. There was no further comment as to the sudden cancellation, but there were speculations that the company surrendered due to the overwhelming backlash. Coincidentally enough, this was also taking place when the Me Too movement was starting to spread in South Korea. Leader Yua also posted on her social media a handwritten letter discussing the unprompt cancellation. "The first fan showcase that we, Honey Popcorn, planned with our debut was cancelled. We are truly sorry. We sincerely love K-pop and respect K-pop, so a debut was our dream come true. We worked on the album purely out of love and passion for K-pop. We are still trying our best to make this work. We understand that in Korea, there is concern about us debuting, but if you could give us the chance to make a small step to debuting and performing as a K-pop group, we won't let you down. Please try to support us. Thank you." Not too long after their first announcement, Kyun Create retracted their statement and announced that Honey Popcorn's showcase and activity would recommence. He also ended it with, "All three members are working hard to prepare for their debut in order to show Korean fans a wonderful appearance." At their showcase, the members gave a fun-filled performance where they performed their own music and did some K-pop covers and followed up with an interview. We also got to see them open up and share their personal thoughts on the backlash they received. Leader Yua shared with the crowd, "I am engaged in such work in Japan. I also consider that work serious, but right now, I want to focus on promoting Honey Popcorn." She continued, "I understand there are people who find it difficult to support us. I want to think preciously of the ones who do give us support, and it'll make me happy if they continue to give us more support." Miko also added, "While preparing for our debut, I expected there to be varying opinions since there are cultural differences in Japan and Korea. We will work hard to live up to the expectations of the ones who give us support, and I hope the number of people who will like us will increase. All three members show to have a genuine love and passion for K-pop. Like I said earlier, later Yua funded Honey Popcorn's debut entirely herself. It truly was a passion project and dream of hers to debut as a K-pop idol. She has also shown her love and interest for K-pop and Korean culture over all her social media platforms. Even in their debut showcase, she said that APINK's Mr. Chu is what drove her interest into K-pop in the first place, and she would like to see them perform one day. They actually also performed Mr. Chu while busking in Korea. A few months after their showcase and debut, it was announced the group would be holding their very first fan meet, but with some interesting restrictions. The fan meet would be limited to 18+, yet it was not specified why. The age restriction caused even more criticism and drew further speculations. On the other hand, fans of the group had high expectations for the fan meet, considering the rule. The group did receive much backlash for their past line of work, but they also received an outpour of support and fan base of international fans and some K-nets. But even in their own fan base, inner conflict arose. Distribution was a main issue amongst the fans, specifically speaking of their screen time distribution. The song was pretty much equally distributed, but 90% of the music video was solo shots of Yua. On one hand, fans argued that because Yua funded the music video herself and is the group center, that she has the right to have more screen time. It is also very common in J-pop music videos for the music video to focus on some members more than the others, and the spotlight is usually rotational. On the other side of the argument, others thought that all the members should have equal screen time since they are a group, not just Yua and the others. It was also around this time that Honey Popcorn announced they would be seeking new members to join the group. It came as a bit of a shock to hear the group were recruiting new members, but it was possibly because the company was already aware that they would be losing one of their members. On December 23rd, 2018, Miko announced her departure, or quote, graduation from Honey Popcorn. I will graduate from Honey Popcorn this time. I decided to discuss with the staff and members, everyone who supported us. I am sorry that it was a sudden announcement. There were also a lot of fans who met through Honey Popcorn. I was always supported by everyone, and I was able to do activities. In this harsh environment of K-pop idol, there was a lot of things that we lost. Physical condition without being able to keep up with our mind and body. As it is, it causes inconvenience to members and staff. I thought that the work of my main business might be affected, and I made this choice. I really had a lot of experience and learned a lot. I am truly happy that I could work with my favorite members and staff because Matsuda Miko's activities cannot quit. I'm happy if you keep watching warmly from now on. And I hope to support Honey Popcorn with you as members of the fans. Fans, members, staff members, I'm really thankful to you. A year after their debut and Miko's departure, Yua posted a YouTube video via the official Honey Popcorn account and updated the fans on their group's future activities and new members. She said that Kyun Create tried to sway Mnet to produce a reality show that would announce the new members, as well as focus on their day-to-day life. However, Mnet were not interested in partnering up with the group, probably due to the past work history. They were, however, able to work out a partnership with an app called Mista. On July 5th, 2019, the girls made their second comeback. The new lineup consisted of Yua, Sakura, Nako, Ruka, and Sara. With their recent comeback, the girls still kept the bright and colorful concept. Their song was nothing out of the ordinary and didn't stand out from any songs releasing around the same time. And to add on top of that, the song couldn't even chart on the Korean music charts. On the bright side, the screen time distribution was distributed better, except for the lines. The girls held their second showcase to commemorate their comeback and show off the new members. They even performed their debut song as 5. During their interview portion, Yua talked about her experience during their debut. I heard various opinions when I was working on the first album. There was some criticism, but I thought I couldn't give up on the first album, so I tried the second album. She continued, My job in Japan is a negative job in South Korea, but I'm still doing my best with pride. I want to work not only in Japan, but all over the world. What can be considered a failed attempt at a comeback, the girls became increasingly quiet over social media, with the exception of Yua. Many groups rely on individual or group activities and promotions to keep them funded as a group. And due to their background, they were severely limited to opportunities that even most rookie groups are able to obtain. Many thought that this might be the end of Honey Popcorn. Honey Popcorn was more of a side project for Yua. She started her own clothing brand and is an influencer and continues to do AV work. The other members seem to have their own modeling gigs and work opportunities in the meantime. Besides that, not much news has come out about any comeback or group activities. Many netizens identify them by their past and can't separate their line of work with their idol career. Because of this, Yua, as well as some of the other members, have embraced their past and current line of work, which may be the reason for their limited edition set promotion. Honey Popcorn received much backlash before their debut and had to jump over many hurdles to prove themselves as idols. Despite their limited promotions and opportunities, they did fairly well for their debut, but their initial support started to die down. The group was able to hold many concerts outside of Korea, such as in Japan and America. Do you think the group has another chance of a comeback, or is this really the end? Also, what are your thoughts on the K-Nets getting the Korean government involved? Was it necessary, or could they have gone about it in a more reasonable manner? Let me know all your thoughts and comments down below. And as always, thank you for watching and enjoy your stay.